Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to City Skylines. Today, we have another Let's Build for you. This one is going to be a hiking trail that meets a national park. It is a combination of those two things and is very much an experiment in landscaping in City Skylines for me. Landscaping is not something I've done a lot of in the past for any of my Let's Builds. I know the tiered cities were very much reliant on landscaping, but I wouldn't call those landscaping in the sense that they were anything natural. This was an attempt at making some fairly natural looking mountains, but I do consider this to be a huge experiment. And that's for two reasons. Number one, because I haven't done anything like this before. And number two, because if you look at this entire build from behind or from too far away, the entire illusion will break down. So I want you to think of this like a huge movie set, in that from certain angles and in certain places, it's gonna look great. It's gonna look real and it's gonna look like it exists. When you sort of break the fourth wall, not so much. Anyway, a little bit about the build. This is something I put together over about 7 hours on a live stream with some feedback from the chat. And it is, like I said, a national park crossed with a hiking trail. There are no roads, there are no buildings, no zoning. It is all gravel paths with a few concrete bridges. There are two little streams that lead out into the Grand River. I think this might very well be the Grand River map, but if it isn't, then that is just a Grand River. And there are a lot of trees. In the end, easily tens of thousands of trees, a lot of different rocks, and a lot of toying around with, well, water levels to start with, but a lot of toying around with the landscaping tools within City Skylines, or should I say within the extra landscaping tools mod, because none of this would have really been possible without that, as is the case for most creative projects in Cities Skylines. Now, this one for me was particularly interesting because it has been such a long time since I tried anything like this in Cities Skylines. Even Emerald County, when I was running that series, didn't have that much of a reliance on terraforming. And if we're gonna go for one of my Let's Builds in the past that has had a reliance on terraforming, excluding the tiered cities because they were built on just flat levels, I guess there is the City of Tomorrow, which had some mountains around it. But before that, it would be the Canals Town, which I think was one of the first Let's Builds in the channel. Obviously, the Canals Town was basically a town built on canals. What more can I say? So that was sort of the extent of the terraforming there. Now, back to this build. You can see at the moment I'm going ahead and placing in some of the various paths around here. Something I wanted to do as much as possible with this build was create some interesting places to walk to. I wanted to create some views, basically. So there are places throughout this build where you can just imagine yourself standing and looking out across this river, and in a few places, I really do wish I had built some kind of city across the river from this national park, and I might still very well do that. There might be a part two of this at some point in the future where I do sit down and I do decide to build some kind of city across from this to sort of finish the map as opposed to just leaving it as this kind of experiment. But I did want to create some views. I wanted to create some places where you could stand and look and imagine there's something out ahead of you, even though there isn't, or where you could stand and look over the river, or in the case of that path that goes under the bridge, you could stand up on the bridge and look down at the other people. You could be down on that path looking up at the other people. And in that area, eventually, in a little bit, we're gonna go ahead and add some park benches and tables, so you could sit down there and have some lunch, and that is fairly central in the entire park itself, so I thought that would be a good place to put that. Now, something I did do throughout the entire build as well, as you can see here, is I constantly came back to the landscaping tool. I was constantly playing around with different elevations and different places for little hills, and I wanted to make sure that the whole thing wasn't just completely flat. I didn't want there to be this huge mountain range on one section, and then down in the footprint of that, I guess in the shadow of those mountains, was this perfectly flat area. And the reason for that was because, well, to be honest, I thought back to high school geography, and I remembered learning about tectonic plates and learning about how mountains are formed and how tectonic plates can crash into each other and then rise up to form these mountain ranges, or they can pull apart from each other, allowing magma to rise up through the crust of the earth and form eventually volcanoes or mountain ranges or whatever. So I realized that there really shouldn't be this perfectly flat area in front of it, both from my basic understanding of that kind of geography from high school and also because aesthetically I thought it just looked a little silly. So I wanted to go ahead and just make it look as good as I possibly could, and that's kind of what this all boils down to. Even though it doesn't look good from a lot of different angles, you know, you look at it from behind, like I said, or from across the river, it does look very fake. It does look like it's an unfinished project, and I do want to, again, stress that, that it was an experiment, but even with all that, I am very pleased with it, and I'm very pleased with how the aesthetics of it turned out. And aesthetics is always a word that makes me feel like I sound really pretentious. It's just one of those words, you know, the aesthetics of the build. But it's a great word for describing this kind of thing. Anyway, I think I have explained the build in the best way that I possibly can. There is a lot of this video left, so I'm gonna do a little bit of rambling like I usually do. But I would like to let you know that this map is available on the Steam Workshop. As are, I believe, all of my Let's Build maps, I think. A lot of them are, anyway. I don't know if all of them will necessarily work. I don't know if any of the mods that they might have relied on are gonna be updated, but I believe most of them are gonna be on the workshop. This one is included. And what I'll do is, in the description of this video, I will link to the map. But in the description of that map, I will link to a collection of assets that were used to create this map, because very, very, very few of the trees and rocks that I placed are actually in the base game of City Skylines. They were all custom rocks and custom, well, not all of them, but most of them were custom rocks. Most of them were custom plants as well, and you will not be able to play this the way it's intended to be played if you don't have those things. Now, what you're seeing me do here is go ahead and place in a whole bunch of trees with the tree brush. Originally, I wasn't going to do that, and you will have seen it a couple of moments ago. I was placing every tree by hand individually. I decided very, very quickly that that was not a good idea because it was going to take a very long time to place all of those trees individually. And this still took a long time. This is like after an hour and about 90 minutes is where I am here. And there was, you know, another while on top of that. So even when I wasn't placing every single tree by hand, this still took an enormous amount of time. So I am kind of glad I decided to use the brush and then go in afterwards to enhance the work that the brush had done. I wanted to make sure I had a lot of areas that were very distinct. I wanted to make sure that there were a lot of distinct areas in the sense of there were these bridges and all that stuff, but I also wanted to make sure that the tree lines were quite distinct as well. I wanted to make sure that there were areas of incredibly dense trees as well as areas that weren't quite as dense. I also wanted to make sure that a lot of my waterways were lined with these kind of, I can't remember what they're called, but they are along the edge of a lot of rivers, and they always look a little bit overgrown, and I wanted to make sure I had a bunch of these alongside areas where there was going to be water, which is exactly what I did there. You'll notice I carved away a space for the second stream of water to come down from the very top of the mountains, which, by the way, I should stress, is very unrealistic. There is just a mysterious lake up there. That's another thing that I mean when I say this isn't necessarily designed to be viewed from every single angle. I might go back and I might see what I can do about changing that. I could get the 81 tiles mod, which I didn't actually use for this. I could get the 81 tiles mod, and I could very well turn off the edge fog on the map, and then expand my mountain range back so it looks like the water is coming in from the edge of the map rather than just existing at the top of this mountain. But what I think I'll do is, I suppose, throw that out to all of you. Would you like to see? I will advise that you wait until the end of the video to see the finished product, but I'll ask it now because we're about 10 minutes in and that's like the average watch time anyway. Would you like to see a part two of this where we attempt to build some kind of town opposite this and we attempt to fill out the map with this let's build? That might very well lead into a part three. I'm not promising a lengthy series, but three parts of this, and I reckon we could fill out a map with a reasonable attempt at a grander scale let's build than I've done in the past, barring perhaps Emerald County. What you can also do, of course, is, like I said, with this being in the workshop, you could go and download it yourself and see what you can do with it. And I would encourage you to do that and tweet the results to me, because I'd be very interested to see what other people would do with this map. That's part of the fun of sharing them, is that you can play them as well. You can mess around with them. You can see how something was built. You can see how something was done. You can tweak it. You can adapt it, and you can make that map your own in a lot of senses. So I would highly recommend that you do go and download the map and play around with it if you have Cities Skylines yourself. Now, with that said, what are we doing at the moment? Well, it was around this time that I realized I wanted to get a lot of rocks into the park. I wanted to get these in here because there isn't that much detail in the mountainsides, and I wanted there to be. I wanted this area to look very, very rugged in a lot of ways. And I'll be honest, a lot of that sort of came from my interest in kind of fantasy movies. Lord of the Rings, The Hobbit, etc. All those kind of movies where the mountain ranges, unless it's Hobbiton in Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit, the mountain ranges are very harsh, I suppose. They're always quite rough and rugged, I guess. And that's why my mountain ranges are sort of always like that. Every movie I've seen that's fantasy or even sci-fi to a degree, the mountain ranges are always very sharp and distinct. And I like that. I really, really do. And one thing I've always done in Cities Skylines with these let's builds is I've always sort of exaggerated the detail in certain areas. I've always made the grass a bit longer than it should be. I've always put some kind of shrubs in the grass to make it pop a little bit. In this case, what I decided to do was go ahead and add these rocks to the mountain ranges to make them a bit sharper, a bit taller, and to make them a little bit more exaggerated. So if that's not your thing, I do apologize, but I just did it as a way to add a little bit of extra detail to some things that were otherwise going to be pretty much one color and very, very flat indeed. This also lets the lighting in the game sort of bounce off the rocks a little bit, cast some more shadows, and just add much-needed depth to all of these hills. I also use these rocks to detail some of the backgrounds. Again, you have to think of this like a movie set. I made everything look as good as I possibly could. When you're looking at this thing from a few angles, or if you're down in this park, but again, if you look at it from behind, or from the wrong angle, or from above, the illusion will break. But again, that is completely fine. Anyway, I have done my best to not ramble too much, but I really, there's not a whole lot more to say. A lot of this video is going to be placing all sorts of trees and really getting as much detail in here as I possibly can. So let's talk a little bit about what I was up to during the build process. Well, like I mentioned, this was a live stream. I've recently gotten back into streaming a bit more regularly. I went through a period in December of barely streaming at all. In fact, I think in December I streamed about 4 times across the month, which is not very good at all. I'm pretty sure I've already done more streaming in the last 2 weeks than I did in the entirety of December. Possibly. Maybe the past week. I know that in 2 days I did 12 hours of live streaming. This build in particular was 7 hours. I streamed the day before for 5 hours. I played Grand Theft Auto online with some people in the stream chat. By the way, anytime I do go live, I will always post a video to the channel announcing it. I'll also tweet about it, and if you follow me on twitch.tv/conflictnodeTV, you should be notified via email that I'm going live as well. If you ever want to come along to those streams, you are more than welcome to do so. In the case of a Cities Skylines live stream, you are more than welcome to throw out some suggestions for whatever I'm working on, unless it is a live recording of a Let's Play, in which case I'll be acting as though it's not live and it's more of just a bonus, hey, come watch this early, but those are very, very rare these days. I usually don't do that kind of thing. But I will probably make a point of streaming more of my Let's Build stuff, especially since I do want to get back into doing more of this stuff for sure. I have missed building these grander projects, and the 1 year anniversary of the Tiered City is coming up in a couple of months. I'm very tempted actually to make another one. And someone on the live stream actually came up with a fairly interesting idea for another Tiered City. So I might very well do another Tiered City for the 1 year anniversary of the original one, the one that sort of started it all, I suppose. I know a lot of you will be watching this video and will have found this channel from that video, which I do just want to mention, actually. The original Let's Build a Tiered City video is the third most viewed, almost the second most viewed Cities Skylines video on YouTube. So a huge thank you for that. That's an incredible honor considering the size of this channel and the size of the channel at the time it took that title. It's been in the top 10 most viewed Cities Skylines videos for a while, and this channel's not been all that big. It still isn't in the grand scheme of YouTube, but I am incredibly, incredibly grateful for that. But like I was saying, when it comes to live streaming, you are always welcome to come along and watch things and take part in whatever way is available. If it's a Grand Theft Auto stream, you are welcome to join if you have Grand Theft Auto Online on PC. And you will also need to be subscribed to me on Twitch, because I very recently opened a public session. A session to anyone that had added me as a friend on the Rockstar Social Club. And we had someone come in who was hacking and cheating and modding the game online, which is against the terms of service of the game. I kindly suggested that he stop. It turned out he wasn't actually watching the stream and was just a friend of someone that was in the game, which meant he could join. Someone in the game informed him that I was streaming for well over 100 people. He started getting very defensive. We then told him that he needed to stop. He started getting annoyed. We then said, we're gonna have to vote to kick him. He said, bye-bye session, and decided to crash all of our clients. I took a screenshot of this, including the text in game where he said he was gonna do that. And I tweeted it to Rockstar Games and Rockstar Support. And interestingly, thus far, have heard nothing. Thanks a lot for that one, Rockstar. Anyway, I think enough about that particular story for the time being, considering that's one heck of a tangent. So what are we up to at the moment? Well, I guess I could say we're up to what we were doing. We're fleshing out all of the tree lines, we're making everything as dense as it can possibly be. We're getting just more of these autumnal trees in here, and that's something I want to point out. You've noticed already, of course, that this is more of an autumn theme than a just generic sort of green trees and all that stuff. And that's because I felt like it was fitting, considering the time of year, although it is more of winter if you're in the northern hemisphere. If you're in the southern hemisphere, then it's summer, but it is more of a wintry time up this way. Which is, I guess, a little bit misleading, considering in winter the leaves have died and fallen off of the trees, as opposed to are only just turning this color. But anyway, I thought this just looked prettier. I thought it would be nicer to bring all this color to the trees, as opposed to just having a bunch of green, because we could have had a whole bunch of green and it just would have looked a bit bland. It really would have. So you just have this sort of this sea of fiery warm color across this entire mountain range, and I feel like if you were done walking through there, it would be so pleasant. And that's something I'm absolutely gonna have to do. I'm gonna have to install the first person camera mod, because I haven't done it yet, and I would encourage you to do the same, because I've seen some views of this at a low angle with the cinematic camera mod, but I haven't seen it in first person. But I'm excited to. I want to go down and walk through this, because I have to imagine it's gonna be super pretty. I really do. That's I'm not sitting here trying to toot me own horn or tickle me own pickle. But I have to imagine it would be super, super pretty done there. Because just the colors, man. Something that did actually inspire this build a little tiny bit is a forest in my hometown, which I walk through from time to time, but I have very fond memories of walking through that forest during winter and autumn, and especially autumn, because the trees do turn all these beautiful shades of yellow and red and orange, and there's the occasional bit of purple in there. It is absolutely beautiful. And if you get a beautiful clear sunset on one of those days as well, one of those autumn days where the sun is just setting perfectly, you just get this fiery warm color across the canopies of the trees that you're walking underneath, and it just feels very, it's comforting, I suppose. Warm colors are very comforting to me. It's why I'm quite a fan of them, and why I always try to, you know, if it's a bedroom that I'm building in The Sims or I'm decorating in real life, I try to make it feel warm because I like that myself. I like feeling warm in a place that's supposed to be comfortable. If it's a place that is like an office, again, in The Sims or in real life, I'm gonna go with colder colors so you don't feel as... You feel comfortable because it's yours, which is what I've done with my studio. I've made it very much my own. I've decorated it myself, I got my own furniture, I put it everywhere I wanted it to be, but the colors are much colder. There's white walls, gray sofa, black tables, the wall behind me is bright green, more so for functionality than decoration, but it does feel a little bit colder, so I don't get too comfortable in here. What does contrast that a little bit would be the electric heater that sits beside my desk and that I rarely switch off because it can get actually very cold out here from time to time. The point is, playing with color is actually one of my favorite things to do. If you've watched any of my... if you watched my Minecraft Let's Build from a few months ago, I think I talk about color a lot in that one. And I do believe in most of my Sims Let's Builds that I've done on the channel over the years. I frequently talk about color in those as well, because color is great, you know? It really is. And I say this every time I start talking about it, but it is, because it can inspire feeling a certain way, it can inspire emotion, it can inspire a sense of royalty or danger or warmth or happiness or sadness, blue, sadness, red, danger, sort of royal blue and royal purple are shades of blue and purple. You know, color really is a great thing, and I do think having this fiery red canopy is a way to invoke a sense of warmth in this build, and I feel like were it to be green. I guess the point of what I'm trying to say is if the canopy was just green, it would number one look very bland and number two feel very, very cold, which isn't what I wanted it to do. Is that a good enough explanation? Have I made my point? I hopefully have made my point with that one, because that was a bit of a tangent, but I don't know. I've always sort of felt that way with colors. I like my warm colors where they're appropriate. I like my cold colors where they're appropriate, and I try not to mix them too much because they can feel very conflicting, I suppose. If you have this really warm color with a very cold color, you sort of, it can often not work, I find. So that's my two cents on color, I suppose. And I guess that filled up like what, 3 minutes of commentary? Good job. That's what it's all about. That's what these videos are all about. Talking non-stop over the footage so you have something to listen to as you're watching. Now what I'm doing there with the path leading out to the little road there was an attempt to go ahead and actually get people walking through here. It didn't work, so I deleted all of that stuff. I deleted the path that went out that way, and I deleted the park I put into the national park, I suppose. And this thing really is just for aesthetics. It really is just a thing to look at, and a thing that you could maybe build onto, a thing that I might build onto, but it really is just for aesthetics. It was just an experiment in landscaping, an experiment in detailing things naturally, an experiment in laying out something that looks a bit like a national park, a bit like what I think a national park might be, because I've never been to one. I've never been to a national park, ever. I've not been to anything that resembles a national park in my life. I don't really go anywhere. Anyway, ladies and gents, that is going to be it. There will be some cinematics at the end of this video. Thank you kind of for watching. If you liked the video, like the video. Don't forget to share it on social media. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.